वेलकम बैक डियर चिल्ड्रन. सो आवर चैप्टर नंबर 3 रिलीजियस सिंथेसिस इज गोइंग ऑन एंड इन आवर लास्ट वीडियोस वी हैव लर्नड अबाउट भक्ति मूवमेंट. नाउ लेट अस कंटिन्यू विद द सेम. नाउ वी हैव बसवेश्वर. In Karnataka, Basaveshwar spread the Lingayat stream of thought. Thought means, you know, Lingayat stream means what? Lingayat is nothing but a sect. Sect means what? Group of particular people. Lingayat is a group of people who do not believe in caste system. For them, all are equal. They reject the caste system. Such group of people are known as Veerashaiva Lingayats. I repeat, such group of people are known as Veerashaiva Lingayats. In Karnataka, Basaveshwar spread the Lingayat stream of thought. He opposed the caste system and stressed the dignity of labor. What is this dignity of labor? It means all occupations, intellectuals, those who are working in multinational companies, for example, or those who are doing physical labor, should be considered equal. No job should be inferior or superior. Have you understood? So, work It's Kailas or work is worship is a well-known saying. You all know. So, this saying explains us the real meaning of dignity of labor. He encouraged women's participation in his movement. Men and women belonging to all castes began to participate in the religious discussions conducted in the hall. Anubhav Mantapa. Do you want to see the hall Anubhav Mantapa where the religious discussions used to be conducted? See, this is the hall. Can you see? Yes, and this is the hall known as Anubhav Mantapa. Shri Baseshwar conveyed his teachings in the language of the people. What is language of the people? Kannada. Because he was from Karnataka. So his people's language was Kannada. Through Kannada or through Kannada language, he also wrote Vachana literature. What is this Vachana literature? Vachana literature is a writing to be recited in a rhythmic form, in a tune. Understood? In 6th standard, you have learnt about Vedas, isn't it? So, in Kannada language, Vachana literature was written and used to be recited in rhythmic form. So, that is known as Vachana literature. Basaveshwar's followers have composed their work in Marathi also. Of these compositions, Paramarahasya, composed by Manmath Swami, is very well known. Great saints in Karnataka include Pamp, Purandardasa and others. They also composed many devotional verses in Kannada. So this much we have learnt about Basaveshwar. Have you understood? Basaveshwar was from Karnataka. He spread Lingayat stream of thought, isn't it? And these are the Anubhava Manatapa where the discussions were conducted. Understood? Now let us move on to the Mahanubhav Pantha. In the 13th century, Chakradhar Swami founded the Mahanubhav Pantha. So, Chakradhar Swami, he was from Gujarat. If you remember, you have learnt about him in 4th standard. So, I am sure you know about Chakradhar Swami. He also has established his sect known as Mahanubhav Panth. His sect preaches the devotion of Krishna. Shri Govinda Prabhu was the guru of Chakradhar Swami. Who was the guru? Govinda Prabhu. Govinda Prabhu was the guru of Chakradhar Swami. The followers of Chakradhar included men and women both. They were belonging to all caste and creeds because he supported equality. He traveled to the all part of Maharashtra, preaching in Marathi also. Basically, he was from Gujarat. He was the prince. Chakradhar Swami was the prince of Gujarat. But he traveled all parts of Maharashtra preaching in Marathi also. He preferred Marathi instead of Sanskrit because this led to the development of the Marathi language. Many works were composed in Marathi by Chakradhar Swami. This sect, Mahanubhav Pantha sect, mainly spread in the Vidarbha and Marathwada region of Maharashtra. Riddhipur in Vidarbha is an important place for people of this sect. This sect had reached up to the far away region like the Punjab and Afghanistan. Chakradhar Swami also wrote his good deeds in book Leela Charitra. Basically, the book was written by Mahim Bhatt, but the book, the contents of the book were about Chakradhar Swami, and the name of the book was Leela Charitra. Mahanubhav Pantha was his sect. His famous book was Leela Charitra, describes his deeds, means his good work, and written by Mahim Bhatt. So, have you understood about Mahanubhav Pantha? Let us move on to Guru Nanak. Guru Nanak was the founder of Sikhism and the first guru of Sikh. So, who was the first guru of Sikh? Guru Nanak. After Guru Nanak, 9 gurus were there, and finally, 10th Sikh guru, Guru Gobind Singh, was their guru. But after his death in Nanded, all Sikh people regard Guru Granth Sahib, their holy book, as their guru. So Guru Nanak was the founder of Sikhism. His work has to be mentioned as a great attempt at religious synthesis. He used to visit both Hindu and Muslim holy places. He had also visited Makkah. You know, what is Makkah? Let me show you. Children, this is Makkah. Makkah is a holy place in Saudi Arabia. And this is Islam's holy place. Only Muslims are allowed to go there. See the picture. This is the picture of Makkah. So he had visited to Makkah also. He realized that the feeling of devotion is common everywhere, you know. He taught that all persons should be treated equally. His teachings aimed at achieving Hindu-Muslim unity. And he also emphasized chaste behavior. What is chaste behavior? Pure relationship with wife after marriage only. Many people were influenced by the teaching of Guru Nanak. The number of his followers increased day by day, and the followers of Guru Nanak are known as Sikh. Followers means disciples, Shishyas, Shishya Varga. The Adi Grantha, Guru Grantha Sahib, is their holy book. The Adi Grantha includes composition of Guru Nanak, Sant Naam Deo, Sant Kabir, and other saints. Guru Nanak was succeeded by 9 gurus. And the 10th guru was Guru Gobind Singh. After Guru Gobind Singh, Sikhs regard the Guru Granth Sahib, their holy book, as their guru, as per the orders of Guru Gobind Singh. So this much we have learnt about Guru Nanak. Let us move on to the last part of the chapter, and that is the Sufi sect. What is this Sufi sect? This is a sect again. A group of particular people following the particular thing. This is a sect in Islam. The Sufi saints believed that God is full of love and the only way to reach to God is through love and devotion. Do you want to see the pictures of some Sufi saints? Let us see. These are the Sufi saints. Meditation and simple living is the key of devotion and love to reach to the God. Khwaja Mohiuddin Chisti, Sheikh Nizamuddin Awliya were the great Sufi saints. The teaching of Sufi saints led to unity in the Hindu and Muslim communities. Sufi music has made valuable contribution to Indian music. You know, Sufi songs are there. If you go to YouTube, you will find number of Sufi songs are there. See, these are the singers singing Sufi song. So the path of bhakti taught by the saints was easy to follow for the common people. The bhakti movement was open to all men and women. The saints expressed their thoughts in the language of the people. Common language. The common people found them close to their heart. And the bhakti movement has contributed greatly to the making of the Indian culture. So this much you have learned in chapter number 3. We will continue the exercise at the back of this lesson in our next video. Till then, read the lesson and learn the important points. Bye bye, children. See you, children.